Studio by Garden Streets gives you the opportunity to explore a new hobby, enjoy a new experience, or have a fun date night.
And joining us now with some ideas to celebrate Galentine's or Valentine's Day, or both, is founder Jen Gouldstone. Thank you so much for coming in again.
Yes, my pleasure.
This is great. So let's jump right in.
Yes.
So this is the new crocheting, huh?
Yes, that's right. So this is a chunky knit blanket.
Look
it has two different patterns.
Look at this.
If you flip it, it has a different pattern on the other side.
Oh, look at that.
So I'll show you how to do some loops, and then the same kind of yarn can be used to make pillows.
And
very warm.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Very warm.
All right. So let's get started.
Okay, so we've got some pillows there too.
That's right.
Okay.
We'll stuff the pillows after.
All right. Okay. Awesome.
Wonderful. Why don't we get started?
So I'm gonna demo over here. We have some loops started already for you. Mm-hmm. So basically to do a row, you're gonna take, this is our working yarn that connects to the rest of the yarn. You're gonna pull it through.
Okay.
And then you move on to the next loop and you pull it through.
Oh.
And then
you
keep going. And then when you get to the end, you come around the other way.
So you gotta be careful not to pull. Too much so you don't get the other loop.
You don't want to make it too big.
Okay.
And as much as you can make it about the same size, then your blanket will be nice and consistent.
Okay.
Yeah. One of the things we see is people get tighter and tighter loops, and they end up with a trapezoid.
Okay.
But it's warmer that way, too.
Yeah. Okay.
So it can't go wrong. We do these workshops. You come in. Beginners are totally welcome. You don't need to know how to knit or crochet. We show you how to do this. You don't even need needles.
Are kids able to do this?
I would say 8 or 9 and up. You just need a little bit of attention span and patience, and then you're
patience,
good. Yes, we have had 10-year-olds do this, and it's beautiful.
Okay.
They love it so much at the end.
So this is what we're working on as a blanket, but you can also make pillows.
Yes. That's right. So we have a couple of, how are we doing on your first row?
First row's doing pretty good.
You're done. And then you're just kind of going back and forth.
Back and forth.
And you grow the blanket outward.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing.
How long does it take to do a blanket real quick?
With that size, depends on how much yarn you want to use, but 90 minutes to 2 hours is how long that blanket we looked at earlier
would
have taken. So it's very doable within one
setting.
Yeah, it's
super soft for the winter. I love it. It feels great.
Mix the colors up. It's awesome.
Okay, so here's your pillow.
We've got some pillows ready for you
to
stuff, which is really, really fun.
That's
you pick
fun.
Your colors.
Okay.
And generally speaking, you have these, you know, pillow stuffing bits. Half of these will stuff one pillow, but I have two things here. So you can, depending on how tight you want your pillow to be, the more you put into it, the tighter it will be.
That's fun.
Ooh, this is
kind of a fun mess.
And you were pointing out that this is washable.
Yes. It is machine washable.
That's
machine
amazing.
Washable, which is so important, you know,
for
anything
in the house.
Okay, is that
big enough?
That's pretty good. That's great. We put a little bit in.
And what's great about it is you go to your workshops, the mess stays with you.
Yes, yes. We clean up, we set up, we do all of that. So when you're done stuffing it, you gently just pull that. Keep going.
It's like a drawstring?
Yes. And then look at that. It comes together like a pillow.
Look at that.
And then we tie off the loop, stuff that little tail back in, and you have a pillow right there.
Look at that.
That is really
nice. And I imagine you can make this as big or as small as you want.
That's right. We've actually used the same technique to make cactus pillows, mushroom pillows. That's 102 for our knitting piece.
Okay.
Super fun. And if you want a little bit of beer with your... craft, you can do craft and craft. We're doing some of these events with local beer, with breweries.
Oh, that's fun.
As well.
All right.
So find that info on our website.
Okay. This is fun.
We need to get our liquid. Oh, that looks good.
Okay.
Looks good.
I like that. That's fun. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so we got duckies.
Duckies
are pour art, and there's different things you can pour liquid paint onto. And it's, you know, here are some examples. You can do canvases, you can do duckies of various sizes, and we have a bear family.
So cute.
Babies, toddlers, teenagers, and mom and
papa. Okay, so you can make a whole little family,
a
collection or
totally.
A village.
Totally, so you can do a pair. What we're gonna do is you can each pick maybe 2 to 3 colors.
Okay.
I recommend higher contrast colors. That way when you have the streaking, you'll see it more. White's always a good color to mix in as well. That's a good Valentine's Day mix.
This?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, that one.
No, okay. The pinks. You got the pinks. That's a good one.
You want to do a blue, maybe to contrast?
Okay. A darker blue or a lighter blue?
They'll look I don't know.
Yeah.
There you go.
So this is fun to choose your colors.
Yeah, that's where the whole, you know, yeah. It's like, oh, I feel, okay, I'll go with those three.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. So we're gonna pour alternating the colors. You're gonna do color one, color two, color three, and then come around, color one, color two, color three. Yeah.
Okay.
And then we're gonna get it to just about half, and then we're gonna pour.
So we go color one.
Yep. You don't have to do a ton, and because we're gonna redo that cycle.
Oh, got it. Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Color two.
Okay. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Oh, this is good. I can't wait to see. Everything is unique when it comes out. You can't control it too much,
but
it's going
to
look
amazing. And then we go back to the
beginning? Yes.
One.
That's right. You alternate it a little bit. Because then that gives you the streakiness as you pour it across your duck.
Uh-huh.
Oh, look at that.
Three. Okay.
Okay.
Beautiful.
Is that enough?
When you're ready.
Okay.
We're ready. So you want to just start from the top and just nice and slow and pour it in and see where you want to
kind of where
cover
it goes, right?
Yes.
Okay, you just let it
just
flow.
Let it go. Look
let
at
it
the
go.
Colors.
Ooh, that's
oh,
fun.
Wow.
That's super satisfying.
I love it.
Whoa, that's cool.
Oh, man.
Get some of the beak. You still have some orange in the front.
Oh,
this does take about a day to dry, so you don't want to move it too much, but just let it sit and let it become its own.
Yeah, become in whatever it wants to.
Right.
Ooh, I love this.
You cannot go wrong with this.
No, you can't.
Yeah, no.
And it'll always be unique.
Right. And you can also add glitter onto it. You know, workshops use a lot of other materials you can use too.
Oh, man.
Look at
that.
You can really get your decks in a row.
You've been waiting to say that one, haven't you? You sure have.
Well, that's the spot in the front. Oh, no.
Oh, cool.
You can always get a little more paint too. Same color combination. You can add on to it if you missed anything.
Oh, yeah.
We
yeah.
also have paint brushes sometimes
so
that we use to add a little more.
Okay.
But you can just
so
do
fun.
Another round of the same color and get where it was missed.
Mm.
Oh, don't
okay.
worry about it. That's
there,
okay.
There we go.
Yeah.
And that's the whole idea. It's just a fun
to
event.
Do your
yes.
thing.
Yes.
And
yes.
make your own creation.
It's so easy. So easy.
The workshops like are fantastic too, because also I know we've done the dried flowers before, the shadow boxes. You have some great workshops out there.
Thank you.
Some fun things to do for Galentine's Day and Valentine's Day. Studio by Garden Streets, it's in the New City Plaza in Lincoln Park on North Halsted. STU_Chicago are the social media handles, and studio.gardenstreets.com is the website. Jen, these are so much fun.
This is fun.
Thank
we got to go.
Yeah, look at it.
Amazing.